Happy Monday. Surprise. I'm doing a surprise live video today. I didn't tell you guys about it ahead of time because I honestly wasn't really planning on doing a video because I don't know if you can hear, my voice is a little nasally today, so I didn't want to do a video, but I had to share these recipes with you that I'm meal prepping today because they are so easy and simple. And there's two different recipes with, one has 6 ingredients and one has 4 ingredients. So they're too simple not to share. I know you guys would love these recipes because in this group it's all about keeping things simple and easy but still healthy. So I wanted to just show you guys what I'm prepping. And so for those of you that are seeing me live right now, hello, and you'll be able to watch the replay if you're not able to watch the live right now. So we're gonna start off with a really easy Mexican quinoa. And these are all just straightforward, simple ingredients, as you'll see. So our first ingredient is obviously going to be quinoa. So, and these recipes are gonna make 6 servings. So whether you're just you can, you know, half the recipe, or you can just make a big batch to meal prep for the week. So let's start with our quinoa. So I'm just gonna throw in this whole bag into a pot. It's about 2¼ cups, I believe, when I measured it the first time. And then we're going to do the whole box of vegetable broth. So that's your second ingredient. First ingredient is just white quinoa. Second ingredient is vegetable broth. Pretty simple, right? And each broth box like this is about 4 cups. So I know that it's about a 1-to-2 ratio. So 2 cups of quinoa is about 4 cups of liquid. And I always like to use broth because it gives the quinoa more flavor. So opposed to using water, when you have broth, there's a lot more flavor. So you can either do vegetable broth, chicken broth, really whatever you like. For this one, I like vegetable broth. All right. And our next ingredient is going to be taco seasoning because we're doing a Mexican quinoa. So to add flavor in a really simple way, we're just going to throw in some taco seasoning. A lot of people think it's just for meat, but you can use taco seasoning in a lot of stuff. Quinoa, soups, different sauces. It doesn't always just have to be for meat. So I'm going to do most of the packet, probably about 3/4 of the packet in there. All right, so that's what we're starting with. That's our base for this quinoa. It's just quinoa, vegetable broth, and taco seasoning. So I'm gonna put this on the stove, turn it on, bring it to a boil, and then once it starts boiling, I'll reduce it to a simmer. So I'll go put this on the stove, be right back. Quinoa is on the stove, turned it on high heat to bring it up to a boil, and once it comes, like I said, we'll reduce it to a simmer. So that recipe is going to be pushed to the side for now while the quinoa cooks, and we're going to move on to recipe number 2. So let's see, a big tray here. This is going to be pesto baked chicken. It's really good. It has 4 ingredients. That's it, right? How easy is that? So these are both, like I said, easy meal prep recipes that you can make for the week ahead or just make for dinner one night because they're so easy and simple. And they each can be made in under 30 minutes. So even better, not only are there a few ingredients, but they're quick too. So I'm starting off with some chicken breast here, just boneless, skinless chicken breast. And I already trimmed it up. So just take off any of the fat on the ends or the edges that you see that you want to trim up. And we are just going to put it on a baking sheet that is lined with tin foil and parchment paper. I like to use both because the foil helps keep the pan clean and the parchment paper keeps things from sticking. So let's just add all the chicken. sheet. You guys can see. There we go. And I'm just gonna do a little bit of garlic powder on top of them. So we'll start with that. A little bit of garlic powder, or garlic granules, I should specify. There we go. And next is gonna be our pesto. So when it comes to pesto, you can buy store-bought pesto or you can make it yourself. Whatever you find is easiest. Most of the store-bought pestos have dairy in them, like Parmesan, different cheeses like that. So if you are dairy-free, make sure you look for a pesto that doesn't have dairy or you make your own. And I have a few recipes for pestos on my website, totalbodynourishment.com. There's, I think, 3 different pesto recipes on there, so feel free to use one of those. Or you can buy a store-bought pesto if you'd like. I know Whole Foods carries one without dairy, so just read the labels if you are dairy-free. All right, so all we're gonna do, just put the pesto on top of the chicken breast. And we're just gonna spoon it on. Do about 2 spoonfuls. This is really dependent upon how much you like also. So if you like things with a lot of sauce and pesto flavor, you can put a lot of pesto. And so you just wanna coat the top of it. Can you guys see? You just wanna coat the top of the chicken breast. And we're just gonna do that for each one. This is really good because the pesto, not only does it add a lot of flavor, but having a layer of pesto on top of your chicken will help keep it really moist. It locks in the juices of the chicken and the pesto just seeps into the chicken and gives it a ton of flavor. So really yummy. And you'll see what we're gonna do with this. You can preheat your oven to 425 degrees Fahrenheit for this recipe. So like I said, all we have so far is boneless, skinless chicken breast. And I did a little bit of garlic granules on top. And now I'm doing some pesto. And like I said, 425 degrees Fahrenheit for your oven temperature. This is so good. And we're gonna top it with tomatoes, sliced tomatoes, and a little bit of goat cheese. But you can leave the goat cheese off if you are dairy-free. That is totally fine. It's just as tasty with just the pesto and tomato. And we didn't even need to salt the chicken because pesto is fairly salty in itself. So you don't need to add additional salt, or it might be a little bit too salty. So when you're, if you do buy a store-bought pesto, it might help for you to taste it, to see how salty it is, and if it's not that salty, you can add a little bit of salt on your chicken if you like your food salty. But typically, pestos that are store-bought are pretty salty in themselves already. So you don't need to add any extra. So as you can see, I'm just layering on the pesto, very simple. And there we go. There's our 6 chicken breasts with pesto. So we have it like that. So as you can see, it's just the top that's coated with pesto. So like I said, 425 degrees Fahrenheit for your oven. I'm gonna go pop these in and we'll set a timer for 20 minutes. Alright, so the quinoa was boiling, so I just turned it down and now it's simmering away. Now I'm going to set the timer for the chicken. There we go. Alright, so let's slice up some tomato for on top of the chicken while we wait for that quinoa to finish. So I don't know if you guys have seen, but I am doing the Prep Like a Personal Chef challenge again. So if you were a part of that last time, You already know what it is, but if you were not, or you're new to this group and don't know about it, it's a 10-day challenge that teaches you how to meal prep and teaches you how to make a large quantity of meals that you can eat throughout the week. It also teaches you how to grocery shop efficiently, how to organize your shopping list, and shows you how to maximize your time in the kitchen when you're doing meal prep, showing you which recipes to start with and different tricks and tips that I use for my clients when I'm cooking at their house. So it's really fun and people get good results from it. And there's a few people that meal prep all the time now because of the challenge the first time they did it. So I highly recommend you checking it out. It's free, so you don't have to pay anything. And you're gonna learn a lot of really valuable stuff. You're gonna learn, like I said, how to meal prep, how to batch cook your meals so you don't have to spend every single day or every morning, lunch, and dinner making something. And it really comes in handy, especially if you're busy, because we don't have a ton of time in the day to, you know, prepare a meal every time we have to eat. So if you don't have something prepared and ready to go, a lot of times you end up eating out or, you know, eating something that's not maybe the best for you. And then you kind of go in this cycle that you don't feel good because you're not eating good, but you don't feel good enough to cook your food because you're not eating good. So it's this vicious cycle that kind of just goes in a round and round and round in a circle. So when you really take the time to make cooking and eating healthy a priority, but you do it in the right way, it doesn't have to be this tedious task. And it doesn't have to take hours on hours of being in the kitchen, doing meal prep. I am showing you how to do things efficiently, which is the most important thing, and how to make healthy eating really simple. And that's what I'm really about, is people think a lot of times eating healthy has to be extremely complicated, but it doesn't. Stick to simple ingredients in their whole natural state and you're gonna be good. And a lot of times people don't even realize how flavorful healthy eating can be. With just some spices and fresh herbs, it really is powerful how delicious healthy food can be when you just prepare it the right way. And so the challenge also kind of teaches you how to cook and how to make healthy eating taste delicious. So if you haven't seen that yet, it is called Prep Like a Personal Chef Challenge, and I will post the link for that after this video is done. So I posted it in this group a couple days ago, so you should be able to see that post to sign up for it. Like I said, it's free. It starts this weekend. So you're gonna get all your materials for the challenge on Friday, and then you have the whole weekend to, you know, do your grocery shopping and then do the meal prep portion for the first part of the week. So now that you'll have all that info on Friday, you can plan it out for when you want to do it. It only takes a couple hours, and like I said, I'm going to teach you how to grocery shop efficiently, so you're not going to be in the grocery store for 3 hours trying to figure things out. Everything's organized, ready to go. All you have to do is download it, print it. You have a whole 7-day meal plan, a bunch of healthy recipes, and you'll be all set. So like I said, that starts this weekend, and signups close on Friday morning at 9 a.m., so don't wait to sign up, and I guarantee you're going to enjoy it a lot. And for those of you that did it before, go ahead and do it again, because you'll have the accountability. It's a new meal plan, so it's not going to be the same as the first challenge, so, you know, why not? It's always good to do something in a group. It keeps you more accountable, and it's really fun. So I encourage you to sign up for that. So I just sliced up the tomato, not too thin, but thin enough. We're gonna top the chicken with this, like I said. All right, I'm gonna check on the quinoa. All right, it's still cooking away, so I'll kind of talk to you about what I'm going to put in the quinoa next, and we can get those ingredients prepared. So the rest of the ingredients in the quinoa: black beans, plain and simple, organic corn kernels. Make sure you buy organic, and I just got these in the frozen section. And then pico de gallo, which this is one of my favorite hacks for, you know, a quick and easy recipe. is using things that are already prepared. And typically I'm not a big fan of, you know, buying things that are already prepared in the grocery store because a lot of times the quality isn't that great. But for something like this, it already has your tomatoes, your onions, your jalapenos, cilantro, all the things that you would put in a pico de gallo, and it's already done for you. So rather than having to buy tomatoes and onions and jalapenos and chopping up all those, limes, everything, you could just have it in this really convenient container. So just make sure you look at the ingredients and make sure there's, you know, nothing bad in it, not any like weird oils or anything. Usually pico de gallos in the store are pretty straightforward. I mean, there's not much you can do to it to make it not healthy. It's just veggies and lime juice and spices usually. So I got the hot one, but you can get mild if you want. So we'll open all these up. And there's a lot of flavor in this too. So it really helps bring flavor to the quinoa. So since you already have the taco seasoning in the quinoa, that's a lot of flavor in itself. But when you add this, it gives it that really fresh flavor, which is what you want when you're cooking. You don't want things to taste super bland and, you know, like stale. So when you add fresh components, it helps brighten up it. It helps brighten it up. Okay, let's get a strainer for these black beans. And you wanna always strain your canned beans because they do come packed in salt water usually. So when you strain them and rinse them, it helps get all that salt water off of them. So I'll just rinse these real quick. Alright, you just want to rinse them until the water runs clear. There we go. They're rinsed. Alright, if you guys are joining me live, say hello. I know I usually do lives at 1 o'clock, so I'm a little bit early, but like I said, today was kind of a surprise video, so I didn't have a specific scheduled time. So if you're hopping on or if you see that I'm live right now, go ahead and say hello so I know you're here. We'll get scissors to open these up. And as I mentioned, you want to buy organic corn. Corn is very heavily genetically modified in this country. And when you are buying organic, you are going to be safe to not have any genetically modified corn. So make sure you look for organic. And I'm just using yellow corn in this. It's really sweet. It adds a good sweetness to the quinoa. I'm going to check on that quinoa real quick. Cooking away. So I'll grab it and show you. I made this earlier. It's what I'm going to put with the quinoa, but you don't have to put anything with the quinoa other than what it already is. But for my client today, he likes a lot of protein, so I'm adding some chicken. And all I did to the chicken was I just put some olive oil on it. I did some salt, garlic granules, onion granules, and black pepper, as well as some dried cilantro. So whenever you're putting a meat with a dish or you're pairing something like that together, you want to keep the flavors the same. So for example, since this is a Mexican quinoa, I put dried cilantro on the chicken to help bring all the flavors together. So when you're doing that, you want to keep everything, like I said, keep some of the flavors so they mesh well together. And so that chicken's gonna fit right in with the quinoa, with that cilantro, and it's gonna taste awesome. So I wanted to show you that in case you are interested in putting chicken with the quinoa, but it's perfect as is because it has the black beans, so you get protein from those. But in case you wanted something additional, you could also do that. I just cooked it at 425 degrees Fahrenheit for 27 minutes. Quinoa is still cooking away. So the key to getting really good, perfectly cooked quinoa is, one, getting the measurements right. Like I said, it's about a 1-to-2 ratio, for quinoa to liquid. And it's all about leaving it alone. So you bring it up to a boil, reduce it to a simmer. But as it's simmering, you don't want to keep stirring it. You want to just kind of let it be. And then once all the liquid is absorbed, you'll know that it's done. And then you can fluff it up and it's delicious and wonderful. All right. Does anyone have any questions about anything so far? These recipes, as you can see, are super simple, and use it as a framework for something else. So, for example, the pesto baked chicken. It's chicken breast, pesto, tomatoes, goat cheese. Those four simple ingredients, but you could make it something else. You could do like a barbecue chicken. You could do chicken with barbecue sauce, pineapple. You could do something like that, or you could make it more of like an Asian flavor with some teriyaki sauce, and you could do some veggies with it. There's a lot of different things you can do if you just look at different flavor profiles. And I know for a lot of people that can be a little bit complicated and confusing, especially if you don't really have much knowledge around cooking. But it's all about just looking at your ingredients. So, and like I said, knowing those flavor profiles. So think of, you know, Asian food. What typically goes with Asian food? It's, you know, soy sauces, teriyaki sauces, those types of flavors with a lot of fresh veggies. So if you just kind of pick a flavor that you want, you can build your dish around that. That makes it a lot easier. And since these recipes are so simple, it's not going to take you a lot of time. You can see I've already got the recipes halfway done because all I have to do once the quinoa comes off is just add these in. And then once the chicken's done, I'll just put those tomatoes on top. So we have about 7.5 minutes left on that chicken. And then we'll put the tomatoes on and a little bit of goat cheese, and then we'll finish cooking it. Let me check on that quinoa again. Alright, it's getting there, but not quite yet. So, I'll give it another minute or two. Does anyone have any questions? I know it's kind of quiet right now, like I said, because I didn't give you guys notice that I was going to do this video. But I really wanted to hop on and show you these recipes, because they're super beneficial for you. They're really simple, really easy, as you can see. So I'll just go over the ingredients with you one more time while that quinoa finishes up. Our Mexican quinoa started off with white quinoa, vegetable broth, and some taco seasoning. And we brought that to a boil, and it's cooking away right now, simmering. And then we're gonna add some pico de gallo, some corn kernels, and some black beans. And then for our pesto baked chicken, we just had boneless, skinless chicken breast, some pesto that we put on top of the chicken breast, and that's cooking in a 425 degree Fahrenheit oven for 20 minutes, and then we will pull it out, add the tomatoes, and then we'll put it back in for another 10 minutes. All right, that quinoa should be good to go, so I'm gonna go grab it. Here we go, we're just gonna add the pico de gallo. We're gonna add some corn kernels. Kind of just eyeball it based on how much you like. And then we're gonna add one can of the drained and rinsed black beans. We've got a spoon so we can mix it up. All right. How easy that was. Wasn't that easy? Now you have this delicious Mexican quinoa. Yum. All right, I'll bring it around and show you. Can you see it? Doesn't that look good? Like I said, we're gonna add the chicken. All right, I'm gonna put this back on the stove, let it sit. We got about 3 minutes left on the chicken before we put the tomato on, so I'll grab the goat cheese. All right. And we're just gonna gently, not gently, but lightly sprinkle this with the goat cheese, the chicken, and then when we put it back, goat cheese will kind of melt on top. It'll be delicious. All right, I'm gonna see if I have any comments. I can't see from here. Okay, no comments. I just wanted to make sure they're working. Alrighty, I'm gonna cut up the chicken for the quinoa. I'll show you a really easy way to cut up a lot of chicken at once. Okay, I'll just move the tomatoes. So when you're cutting chicken and you're preparing it for the week, it's really easy if you just kind of cut it in strips first. And then you can just take the whole breast and kind of just chop it down like that. So once it's already cut in strips, you just have to chop it or slice it. And then you have a bunch of chicken cubes. Just like that. Easy, right? Okay. Let's do the second one. These recipes are so easy. It's like there's not much to do. You can even just do a batch prep of chicken just to have on hand too. I know a few people that do that. They just cook a bunch of chicken so they have it in the fridge for the week, and then they can add it to whatever they want. It's a great, easy way when you do it in the oven. 425 degrees for 27 minutes and you have perfectly moist, juicy chicken breast. Last piece. And this was just 3 chicken breasts. Oh, there's our timer. Okay. So we can put that off to the side. And let me grab the chicken. run away. All right, so the reason we took this out 20 minutes instead of 27 minutes, so we can put the tomatoes on. So all we're gonna do is just very gently put them on top. It's two slices per chicken. Very simple. This is so good. I love this meal. The pesto and the tomatoes, it's just all so flavorful. All right, there we go. And then we're just gonna kind of sprinkle some goat cheese on. And then it'll just melt on top. See what I'm kind of doing? I'm just kind of very lightly sprinkling it with goat cheese. Oops. And that'll be nice and melted. Goat cheese is one of the best dairies you can have. I'm not a huge proponent of eating dairy, but I have mentioned that goat cheese is the better option because it is easier for our body to digest. Goat's milk has a closer match to the enzyme profile of our bodies, so it's easier for us to digest than cow's milk products. And when you're only using a little bit here and there, it's not that big of a deal unless you are intolerant to it. Okay, so there's our goat cheese and tomato, and I'm just gonna go pop this back in the oven, and we're gonna set the timer for 10 more minutes. Ooh, that's heavy. Timer for 10 minutes. There we go. So once that chicken is 10 minutes, it'll be done. It'll be perfect. It'll be nice and juicy and moist. And then I always like to just sprinkle a little bit of ground black pepper on top. That helps give it some spice and some flavor. And yeah, we're done. That's it. Super easy, right? How awesome are those two recipes? How simple. The quinoa only had 6 ingredients. The pesto baked chicken only had 4, not counting, you know, the garlic granules, spices, things like that. But so simple. So just to go over the ingredients one more time for you, we had quinoa, 2 cups of quinoa, 4 cups of vegetable broth, some taco seasoning, and we cooked that up. Then we added some pico de gallo, some corn kernels, and some black beans. And that's your Mexican quinoa. For the best pesto baked chicken, we had 6 chicken breasts, some pesto that we laid on top of the chicken breast, cooked that at 425 degrees Fahrenheit for 20 minutes. Then we took it out, and as you saw, I just put some tomatoes and some goat cheese on top. Then we'll put it back in the oven for 10 minutes, and it'll finish up cooking. And those are your two extremely simple meal prep recipes that you can make fairly quickly with minimal ingredients and all things you can find at a regular grocery store. So I hope you enjoyed this surprise live video. Let me know if you try out these recipes and what you think. And thank you for joining me today. I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your day.